coming to you from the venue that hosted the Super Bowl back in February of 06. Welcome to Ford Field in downtown Detroit. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Ford Field tunnels, and the noise level in this place just about off the charts. They are set for football as the Lions get ready to do battle with the Chicago Bears. On the return, it's Tariq Cohen. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. From the shotgun is Trubisky. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and not the three.
Just short of the 45 at the 44. 12 yards there and a first down.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
And really a nice job there to make something out of that run. Sidestepping defenders for a pickup of four.
It's now second and six.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Trubisky now off the bootleg. And this is a catch by Ted Ginn. Well, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 16 yards, a first down.
First down, Bears.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 36. Here's Trubisky. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it a second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. Ball at a gain of three, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Now that was a big-time play by the defense. They as well knew where the first down line was, and they didn't let him get anywhere near it.
Eddie Pinheiro on now for the Bears. And this will be a 45-yard attempt. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. Well, all offseason, probably a lot of thought goes into that first drive of week one. They didn't get the touchdown, but at least they got something.
And what I like about it is that they didn't overthink it. Because you're exactly right. A lot goes into the offseason, the preseason, to get to that first drive of the regular season. They went right downfield, mission accomplished, points on the board.
Now have it first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Johnson. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady game.
4 yards remain for second down. from the gun, a run for Johnson. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line.
Sometimes I forget how much information he has to go through before the ball's even snapped. But what a diagnosis right there. Saw the play, shot through the gap like a rocket, ends up spilling it for a loss.
The Bears bring out an extra defender in the secondary now for third down. Operating from the gun. Stafford. This is Johnson. He's got it. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
And at the 37-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They toss it out right to Johnson. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Give all that credit defensively to Khalil Mack. A great stop in the backfield. Former Georgia star, DeAndre Swift.
Ball carrier.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Throwing on third down, Stafford. Looking downfield for Jones. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down, so they decline it as that will bring up fourth.
And I know that yardage and field position are keys to any game played, but you've got to consider downs when you're talking about penalties, and they wisely did not take that and made it fourth down.
It'll be a 43-yard punt, just a single yard on the return, and the Bears take over
at their own 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. On first and 10, it's Trubisky. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
Anthony Miller.
23 yards on the play. 23
yards.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
Now Trubisky on first down. And by Miller, that's complete.
Trubisky.
A gain of 6 there on first.
To Anthony Miller.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. There just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. Throwing once more, it's Trubisky. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. A shotgun handoff to Patterson. Daron Harmon makes the tackle.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
6 yards left on second down. Now a give right side. It's Patterson. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Scampering going home from 19 yards out. And the Bears will add on to their lead. Well, they ran the toss, trusting he had the speed to get to the edge, and he did.
And there really wasn't any doubt about that because the scouting report told you that this guy could flat out run. When you give him a little bit of space and a chance to get there, he usually does.
10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. Taken in the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
Lions take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They were forced to punt on their initial drive of the new season. Now they're ready to go as they begin again with a first and 10. First down there, but it's incomplete. Kenny Galladay, the Pro Bowler, was his intended target. That'll bring up second down.
What we've seen so far in this game, they're not going to allow a big shot over the top. You can have whatever you want underneath. They'll give you that, but they're not going to let you beat them deep.
From the 21, it's second and 10. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. A huge play there on the screen pass. 42 yards for an offense that has not found the end zone yet. That's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
The first down carry here for Johnson. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. 2 yards that time, a stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole. That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Stafford with a play fake to Swift, and he'll set to throw. He's got his man, T.J. Hockenson. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Here's Swift. And he takes this one in for the Lions touchdown. DeAndre Swift with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Lions have got it back to a one-score game. Here's Greider for the extra point. And that'll cut it to 3 at 10-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. For their next drive, the Bears offense, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Brings up second.
Here's second and a yard
at the 31-yard line.
with Patterson. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. A gain of back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Second down.
Well, in every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse in a fourth.
And he fires one that's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 46. Return, but you know he's just beating himself up inside for not getting all the way in.
No doubt about it, because he had visions of end zone in his mind, going to be the total hero. But we did see there the emphasis on it's not just good enough to pick it off anymore. Bring it back, get the yardage, and really help out your offense.
Now that sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
And goal at the 3-yard line.
3 yards remain for second down. To Johnson again. And once again, he's going to be stopped up behind the line. Second straight play. Shades of the 85 Bear defense a little bit.
We all know how much running backs love getting the ball down near the goal line. They think they're going to find a way into the end zone. He hasn't had that kind of luck so far. Ends up not getting in on the last 2 carries. You know he's going to be upset about a missed opportunity.
A big play, if you think about it right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. Flush to his right. And he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line.
Third and goal, they decided to throw for it. But how about the play defensively? Couldn't find anyone open. Left him nowhere to go with the football. Had to absorb the sack.
2 minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll again head down to visit with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando, back for another year. He'll have scores from around the NFL here on this opening weekend.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Deron Hoffman. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
They'll run on first down. It's Johnson. And he will cross the 30 down to the 29-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Brings up 2nd and 7 at the 29-yard line.
Running from the gun, Johnson. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up 3rd down. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important 3rd down. Shotgun snap for Stafford. This right caught right around the 6. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Lions have taken the lead. He's got it as they go up by a
total of 17-10. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
They're on 25-yard line.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive? And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
The Lions take over first and 10 at the 50-yard line.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. Now a 10th carry for Johnson. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50.
Johnson, the ball carrier, brought down by Khalil Mack. A gain of a yard. Brings up
from the 50 at Stafford. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one.
The 33-yard line.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. From the gun, Stafford. An incomplete crisis averted. Almost picked. Instead, second down.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Throwing again. Stafford. That's to his running back, Kerryon Johnson. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one.
2 yard line.
On first down, Stafford here. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. And the 13-year man puts it through, and that will do it for this first half. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, we'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive
pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack. That sack by Khalil Mack.
They need to stop to get back into this game, and here's one right to start the third quarter.
Yeah, anytime you go into the lockers with that 2-3 score deficit, you're right. You need that stop, get the football back, and they've done just that.
Series to series, play to play.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. Getting a hand in there and knocking it away, Eddie Jackson.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
Third and long at Stafford. Throwing deep for Galladay. And got his man complete. The 20, 10, and he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. bound. And yes, they want the points, so they will decline the penalty, no question there.
You don't think they spent a couple seconds mulling over what the penalty
is? I don't even know why they asked the sideline.
Not at all. When you put the ball in the end zone on a takeaway, take the points and keep moving.
Extra point good by Prater. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
Trubisky brings the Bears up first and 10 at their own 24. They're going to start the drive here on the ground with Patterson. And he'll get this one up to the 26. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
It's second and 8 at the 26-yard
line. From the gun, it's Trubisky. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Incomplete.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
8 yards to go.
Out of the gun, Trubisky. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 18 yards on that one, and Chicago has the first.
18 on the
on first down. Patterson. He'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
He was tackled at the
oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
First down. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. It's a jet sweep. Here comes Miller. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Desmond Trufant.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
13-yard line.
On second and one, Trubisky. And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. 10 again. There to make the grab. And the Bears get a bit closer.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
Fielded in the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
First and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Stafford going to give this one off to Johnson. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I'll tell you what, this defense hasn't played its best, but they're still right in this football game. If they keep making plays just like that, they're going to give their offense a chance.
Second and 11 now. From the gun, here's Stafford. He completes it to Jones. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down. No gain. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into a huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made, put down right on the spot.
To throw on third down, Stafford. And the goal with a catch. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first. So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. Throwing is Stafford. Screenplay, Johnson. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. A gain of 10 as they look to add on to this 10-point lead. So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Stafford gives to Johnson on the draw. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 11 more yards that go around. A first down as well.
Well, there's zero doubt that the Detroit Lions like Kerryon Johnson's ability, but he's been dinged up a little bit in his first 2 years in the NFL, so they went out and used a day two pick this past year on DeAndre Swift, the rookie runner out of Georgia, hoping, I think, to pair them together and maybe send a message. But I think if Kerryon Johnson can stay on the field, he could be an awfully productive back in the NFL.
A three-yard pickup.
In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Snap will come from the 31 on second and 7. Back to throw. Stafford. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Khalil Mack able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. After the sack, Stafford and the Lions come up on a third and long situation. Out of the gun, Stafford. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
Matt Prater on for the field goal. A 53-yard attempt.
And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. So three field goals that he's hit now. This last one helps him stretch out the lead.
He's been solid, hasn't he? And he lives up to the adage that every offensive coach has ever said does. We want to end every possession with a kick, right? For them, it's either extra point, field goal, or at worst, a punt. In this case, it's been threes.
First and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. To Montgomery to begin the drive. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now at Ford Field. It's Bears football, but they trail on the scoreboard as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now Trubisky. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. A nice little screen. They get six on first down. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Off the play fake. Here's Trubisky. That's complete to Robinson. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down.
And the Bears first down.
Quick pass out to Miller. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Well, they completed the pass, but lost yardage, so they'll decline the penalty.
Perfect play for them, isn't it? Who needs a penalty when you try and throw the ball, you don't even get it downfield, and they go ahead and snuff out the play. They'll take that as a result.
On second down, here's Trubisky. Robinson's got it. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 28. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
First down Bears.
Looking to throw, Trubisky on first down. Got a man, it's Patterson complete. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Second down at four. Trubisky to the end zone, but it's incomplete. He was trying to find Anthony Miller there, and it's third and four.
Brandon, some of those windows that throw the football that exist when you're between the 20s, they don't exist when you're this close to the goal line. But as a former DB, I liked it closer to the goal line. Tighter windows made it easier to cover people, actually.
From the gun on third down, it's Trubisky. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
And the lead will shrink to six.
Makes the score Lions 30, Bears 24.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. Here's a quick throw complete to Galladay. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
On the pickup. Second and six.
And they'll work from the 29 on second and six. Room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
A gain of a yard brings up third.
The Lions on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. This will be third and five. Now it's Stafford. Complete. It's Johnson. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. Not at all what they envisioned on third down. 3 yards in the wrong direction. Here comes the Lions punter now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Six on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. This is fielded at the 27. It's a 43-yard punt, a return of 5, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
At their own 32-yard line.
Checking the NFL scoreboard, they're in the fourth now in Minneapolis. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. A win would be their first of the year. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked by Tracy Walker, and they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line. Well, Charles, he's thrown 5 picks in a game before, and right now, after that one, he's standing on number 4.
And right now, your defensive coordinator is asking the offensive coordinator, can you do anything to slow this down? To keep running back on the field, so play calling may come into it a little bit, maybe run the ball a little bit more, but a lot of it depends on the scoreboard. They may have to keep throwing it.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now Johnson. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine.
Extra bulk up front for second and inches. Three tight ends. From the gun, here's Swift. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. Faking the give to Johnson. Now it's Stafford. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And he has his receiver. That's Jones. Lions touchdown. Marvin Jones, 28 yards. And the Lions are able to extend their lead.
Great field position has to be one of the best friends an offense can have. When you don't have very far to go, you should cash it in with points.
They elect to go for two. Operating from the gun. Stafford. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
First and 10. At their own 20-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to...
And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by Justin Coleman. And they come back deep, got the interception, and now they start inside the 10.
Never forget starting inside the red zone. They're inside the green zone. From the 10-yard line in, a lot of teams call it that because that's the money zone. Get it into the end zone and make your cash.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. Johnson on its point three, footballs out. And this is picked up by the Bears. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Following the fumble recovery, it's Trubisky. Buying time to his left. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
First down.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. They'll throw on first down with Trubisky. He's going to let it fly. And nearly another interception. O'Meara on the ball all game.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Second and 10, it's Trubisky again. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Justin Coleman, and this would have been returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Well, it wasn't always pretty, but the interception there, that means that they should get out of here with a victory.
Yeah, this is not a game that they're going to preserve for posterity on defense, but they did finish it off, didn't they? They did make the winning play, close things out. They'll take that one and head to the locker room.
Buster Screen is able to bring him down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Second and seven. Again, it's Johnson. Three
yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week one in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us. All these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for Detroit, that'll be a happy locker room as they start this season 1-0. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the Green Bay Packers. Meanwhile, for the Bears, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they will be at home next week to take on the New York Giants. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.